Remember the weeks in gym class where you'd unexpectedly drop the laps around the track and instead would learn how to square dance? Well, surprise! If you square danced in gym class, you were unknowingly participating in a super racist tradition. We're not saying swinging your partner round and round is in itself racist, but the reason you were taught to square dance in your elementary, middle, or even high school gym class was actually to fight the Jews who were the masterminds behind jazz? Wait a minute, what? Nostalgia. Under the microscope. The reason many of us learn to roll away to a half sachet is entirely the fault of Henry Ford, the founder of the Ford Motor Company and very notably a well-documented anti-Semite. In the 1920s, he had his own newspaper called the Dearborn Independent that was later reprinted in the overtly anti-Semitic International Jew newspaper. If that isn't enough proof, he was additionally celebrated by Hitler and even praised in Mein Kampf. Later, he denied writing the articles and then also half-heartedly apologized for writing them, which, in that order, happens to be taken right out of a guilty person's playbook. Unsurprisingly, this old, rich, white guy thought jazz and all the new dances of the time were going to completely destroy America. So you're probably thinking, wait, why'd he try to combat jazz with square dancing when Jewish people didn't have anything to do with jazz? And you'd be right. Ford believed that the Jews were actually manipulating the African-American community into creating this new enticing style of music and culture to destroy and take over the world, which is absolutely insane. It's like the inception of racism. Tap the rock in your pocket twice if you think you're caught in a racist fever dream. I've never actually seen Inception. I kept falling asleep through it, which is actually the way you're supposed to do it, so.
That's enough.
So Ford, aka adult man actually scared of a type of music, decided to uphold white people culture by trying to make old-fashioned dancing a thing again, which is coded language for upholding whiteness through dance, which, to be fair, worked pretty well for DDR. And well, frankly, unlike your bedridden grandma, Ford actually had the money to do it. So he poured money into strongly recommending, aka throwing cash at, square dancing being taught around the country, as well as attempting to bring back other historically white dances like the waltz and the French quadrille. He poured even more money into this weird and racist cause by purchasing a violin for $75,000 so he could teach himself the music and bring square dancing back to life by the power of his own dumb little fingers. Money gets you pretty far pretty much always, so eventually he even bought into school curriculums, petitioning and supplying money for programs under the guise of it being a wholesome dance to keep the kids on the right path. In one way, unfortunately, maybe he actually accomplished his goal in some ways, since being good at square dancing is just another way of saying you don't have a lot of friends. So basically, as a result of this one dickhead misattributing an entire musical culture with the wrong minority, we for generations had to do-si-do for a week in gym class with the Dragon Girl. I always got paired with the Dragon Girl. No shade to Dragon Girl, but it was very stressful being roared out spontaneously. It's no surprise that we have a lot of racist coded language and traditions in our culture that we have yet to truly reckon with. I think it's safe to say though that this is by far the weirdest and possibly dumbest one. Have we stopped doing this yet? Or at least can we wheel out the TV and watch a video on the real history of square dancing? Because unbeknownst to numbnuts Ford, square dancing was actually invented by African Americans and has roots in slave history. So Ford, you racist jerk, you burnt. And he's dead, so he didn't feel that, but I'm giving that energy to him. Eventually, all that dirty square dancing money amounted to little more than a short fad and obviously never came close to eradicating the jazz movement. However, the lasting effects were experienced by school children all around the country until the early 2000s. Hey, if you love to square dance, that's fine. No one's saying you have to stop square dancing. We're just saying that Henry Ford brought it to your gym class because he was a freaking freak. Everyone loves chicken pot pie, right? But if you brought chicken pot pie to gym class. People will be like, what? Why is this hot, creamy pie in gym class? Is this making sense?